authorities have their hands full in the southern city of Malmo with an explosion of Muslim immigrants. 90% of them unemployed, many angry. Taking it out on the country took them in.
Civilian deaths in the war in Afghanistan is growing.
More U.S.-led air raids that have killed more innocent civilians.
The increased number of civilian casualties after U.S. airstrikes.
There are some neighborhoods these Swedish ambulance drivers do not go into without a police escort. They've come under threat from angry crowds who tell them which patients to take, which patients to leave behind. The most liberal asylum laws in Europe mean a city of 250,000 is now 250,000 Muslim, changing the face and the idea of what it means to be Swedish.
There is anger in the province of Ghazni. Two civilians were killed.
Five women and two children were among those killed.
Dozens of casualties brought to the main hospital in Kandahar city.
35 civilians were killed and 38 injured.
Between 70 and 100 people are dead.
More than 130 Afghan civilians have been killed.
Nearly 700 civilians were killed.
2,000 civilians were killed in.
Asylum seekers may bring spouses, brothers, grandparents. Civil servants say the city is swamped.
So you have 1,000 pupils in a Swedish school?
Yeah.
How many are Swedes?
Two.
The war in Afghanistan is growing.
More U.S.-led air raids that have killed more innocent civilians.
The increased number of civilian casualties after U.S. airstrikes.
Students arrive at age 10 or 12 from Iraq, Iran, Lebanon, with no knowledge of Swedish. Some have never been to school at all. Special classes require interpreters. Even then, more than half won't graduate.
The war in Afghanistan is growing.
More U.S.-led air raids that have killed more innocent civilians.
The increased number of civilian casualties after U.S. airstrikes.
They are not part of the Swedish society, so to speak. It's difficult for them to get into the society.
And yet they are the most rapidly growing segment of Swedish society, outsiders who are already inside, posing a challenge to legendary Swedish tolerance. Tolerance that has been stretched to the breaking point. The city's main mosque was recently set ablaze by arsonists. When firefighters arrived on the scene to rescue the building, they were attacked by stone throwers.
The very word secrecy is repugnant in a free and open society. And we are, as a people, inherently and historically opposed to secret societies, to secret oaths, and to secret proceedings. For we are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy that relies primarily on covert means for expanding its sphere of influence, on infiltration instead of invasion, on subversion instead of elections, on intimidation instead of free choice. It is a system which has conscripted vast human and material resources into the building of a tightly knit, highly efficient machine that combines military, diplomatic, intelligence, economic, scientific, and political operations. Its preparations are concealed, not published. Its mistakes are buried, not headlined. Its dissenters are silenced, not praised. No expenditure is questioned, no secret is revealed. That is why the Athenian lawmaker Solon decreed it a crime for any citizen to shrink from controversy. I am asking your help in the tremendous task of informing and alerting the American people, confident that with your help, man will be what he was born to be, free and independent.
Civilian deaths in the war in Afghanistan is growing.
More U.S.-led air raids that have killed more innocent civilians.
The increased number of civilian casualties after U.S. airstrikes.
It's the beginning of the second American Revolution.
Tonight, I want the Afghan people to understand. America seeks an end to this era of war and suffering.